Hello and good morning. This is gonna be a bit of a rant once again, as a kind of self-therapy. So it's probably not gonna make it on YouTube, because I think I'm gonna flame about people because I'm pissed. But if it makes it on YouTube, well, then I either forgot to review it or it was fine. But yeah, whatever. There's several things playing together that I'm just not happy with the situation at the moment. And I think it's all just little things, but together they just get to me somehow. I don't feel appreciated. So basically, the idea is that I'm not gonna compare this show in the evening, which I really wanted to do, because, well, I want to try that at one point, and when else do I get the chance to do that? Because I want to set up something in Graz, and if I set up something, then I'll do the compering there. So I'd like to be able to say that I did this before. Now, the problem is that yesterday's show was apparently low energy. I didn't feel that way, not particularly. I mean, I felt like I had energy, but I guess the people have a point, because overall it was probably not energetic enough. So Ollie, who is one of the directors of our week, does not want me to compare, because he thinks he does a better job, and he has the argument that I've never done it before, which is true. However, good morning, Josh. However, I do think that I would do a good job in comparing, because I know myself, and
British Bake Oven's bad news.
And I know that I can get really energetic, especially if I do something for the first time. And one of his arguments is also that it's a Wednesday, and the Wednesday crowd is usually not as participating as on other days. So yeah, that is his problem, but I don't think so. I just think last week's Wednesday had a bad day and a bad crowd, but you can't generalize that on Wednesdays. I just think he takes Ellie's opinion too much to the heart. And there are so many more factors that go into how happy a crowd is. Yesterday our crowd wasn't as well, because it was raining, so everybody had a shit day. But today it's great and sunny, so there are so many more factors. Maybe it was raining last Wednesday. And maybe Ellie just had the impression. I have a completely different problem with Ellie. We're just not compatible people. She just likes to boss people around, and I really don't like being bossed around. So I'm happy that I'm not in her cast. And I particularly said that I didn't want to be in week one, as soon as I knew that that she's in week one, that she's directing week one. And so basically, Ollie just, you know, doesn't want me to compare, which is fair. He has a point. And if I was him, I might even do the exact same thing, because, you know, he would have to trust me to do a good job, and Well, I said that I could do it, but he has zero evidence because I've never done it before, and therefore he just won't let me do it, which is fair enough, you know. I would probably do the same in his situation. However, it pisses me off because I really wanted to do it, and now I can't, and that I don't like. Then there are several other things that get to me, because, for instance, how we selected the games for today. Basically, I was asked, which games do you want to do today? And then everything was already sold out, except for Mannequins and Gibberish Policeman. And so I said, I'll do Mannequins, whatever. Then he said, do you also want to do Gibberish Policeman? Because, you know, you should be in two. I'll do that as well, of course, yeah. But because I do every game, I know that I suck at a few games, but I'll do anyone. But my favorite is Tug of War, and I really want to do that at one point. And then afterwards, we decided to swap a game, so to take Tug of War in, because it was one of the best games so far. It always performed well in the past 2 days. So we took it in, and I was the first to say, "Ooh, can I be in it?" But somehow it didn't really work. Somebody else switched, and then I just couldn't be in it. And then he even said, "Hannah has first dibs on selecting shows tomorrow," for whatever reason, because she was like, she was switching, whatever. I didn't really pay attention. So basically I can't do what I want to do, and I don't even get tips for tomorrow. So that pissed me off. But then again, I have to say I really like Theo's way of selecting it, because he really tries to do a fair job. It was just this little thing that it felt to me like I'm not being appreciated, although he definitely did not do that on purpose. It's just I my mood was already so negative for today's show that I felt this way. And then also when we came here, he was talking to Pavania, at which place she wants to flyer, because we have the morning shift for flyering, and she said she wants to go on the mile. And I would like to go on the mile, because the mile is the best place to fly, because the most thing happens. But then he said I should go somewhere else, because, you know, there are already two people at the mile, because he also wants to go to the mile, for obvious reasons. Then I said I'll go grass market, because I know where that is, and that is here. And here is absolutely nothing going on, which is a good thing, because I'm not planning on actually flyering today. Because I'm so pissed, I just want to go see a show. Hey, can I interest you in some free improv?
Yeah. What is this?
This is at Sports Spa, 6:45.
Awesome, man.
Thank you. So, flyering done. I'm gonna see a show now because I'm so. And, I mean, the others don't know that I'm just buggering off here and not doing my job. And I personally feel like I want to make decisions for myself. Also, they said we can go to shows and then flyer some other time. So officially, that's what I'm gonna do. Inofficially, I'm just gonna go to the show and not flyer, because I'm so pissed off by the whole system at the moment. So much flaming that even the battery died. So I'm just so annoyed and in a bad mood that I just need to show myself that I'm still in control. And I do that by doing what I want, which is running across the street in front of the cars, because the show that I want to see, which is the one from the man in with the coconuts, where I saw a musical yesterday, which was really good, which is why I want to see the show, starts in like 5 minutes. And I hope I can still get in, otherwise I'll do some flyering. But yeah. So, I want to be in control, I show myself that I am in control by not doing what they say, which is what I always do if I get pissed. And that might not be the best quality of myself, which is another reason why I should not put this vlog on YouTube. But then again, I personally feel that it does not make that big of a difference if I go flyer now or not. I'd even say that it is more important for me to have a good mood for the show than to do flyering for the show. Because what's the point in having a good audience if the show is bad? And that is my general problem also with how the show is run. We don't do enough warm-up, we do too much flyering, personally, my opinion. But then again, I'm not a director, so yeah, whatever. I mean, we could do as much flyering and do more warm-up. But it is a problem that, you know, when we're not enthusiastic enough, and I think I can make myself enthusiastic, you know that. If I go on stage, I'll be like, yeah, let's do that! and I can only do that if I'm in a good mood. And I usually am. But at the moment, I feel like, okay, this is venue 274. I need to find venue 301. Hopefully I find it soon, because, you know, show is starting basically now. Yeah, 3 minutes. I have this guide, which is a booklet that I always have with me because, you know, people might want to have it, and PBS wants us to hand them out as well. So we do that. So 200, where did I go? Where did I just walk past 200? What did it say? 200 and... Oh, this might not be on that map because there are no free fringe things there. But okay, I went from Grass Market to there, and then there's another street, and then it's 301. So it must be straight ahead, and then to my right. Alright, let's go there. Try to make a different vlog, because this has just been me ranting about shit. But yeah, those are my feelings at the moment. If I don't like how things are going, I get really angry and do what I want. And I'll always do that. And if people don't want me to employ for that, well, I'm gonna go self-employed. I mean, I think I do a good job in putting up the show. I might not be the best improviser, but that's just because I'm not a good improviser. So, yeah, I do my best. And if that's not enough, well then, bad luck. That's 300 and something. That's 186. I don't really see a system behind those numbers. La la belle, ooh! Ooh! Yes, yes, yes. La belle angele. Or whatever you call that thing. That's where it is. And I hope I can still get in. Right, so you, go make your backup! And don't talk bad about your colleagues. Especially if they are directing your show. But yeah.
You want to turn off and move ahead?
I'll
turn it
right.
Off when it's safe, when it's going.
Nothing against Holly or Theo, but...
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the
Oh man, the man with coconuts are just so good, maybe even the best performers at the PVH Free Fringe, because they have three shows, and I heard from somebody else that their Sherlock show, also have a flyer from that one, oh yeah, that's the Sherlock flyer, is the best show, in his opinion, from the whole Free Fringe, the best free show, he said. So yeah, I haven't seen that one, so I can't really tell, but I'm trying to check it out tonight. They're just so good. Oh man, I like this show even better, even though it only had a 15 minute musical part.
Why can't we be that easy?
And improv games before that. The best part of the improv games was the one where, which is similar to Party Quirks, but the guy who leaves the room is an actor and has to guess what the title of his movie is and who he is. And today he was Arnold Schwarzenegger. And the best part was when the guy to help him, he said, "You come from a shitty little country." I laughed so hard. But man, they're so good. Oh, that made me happy. See, now I'm happy again. That's good. Oh, thank you.
One shirt.
Yeah, I mean, you can check out flyers and then put them in your back pocket and then throw them away later. That's what I do. That's usually people. I think that's what people do if I give them flyers as well. But some come to the show, so it's fine. Yeah. Okay. Now, going back to Grass Market, flyer for 3 more seconds, and then be like, yeah, let's go home. I've done enough flyering. And today I'm not gonna be like, oh, nobody came that I flyered to, because that was the case on Monday. Yesterday, some people came that I flyered. So that was... but yeah, that was good. That was a good show. That was it. Now I'm happy again. Fuck it that I can't compare. Playing the games is fun as well, and I'm here to have a good time, and I just had a good time, so it's all fine. The putting up a show itself, that's secondary. The main thing is to enjoy myself and watching other shows, right? Yeah, I mean, you know, if the one thing isn't working, find yourself another thing that is working. That's the basic idea. Yeah. If the show drags you down, find something that lifts you up again. Found it, did it, done. That wasn't for me. And suddenly flyering is fun again, because we have music and a lot of people here. And I'm in a good mood, so that's way better. It's great, and I like this place because you have a nice view of the castle as well. Also, these things go out pretty quickly. Like tomorrow, I need to take more with me because people want them. And then I can also say, the best show in it is definitely our improv show. All right, see the castle. See me. See that I'm happy again. See that it was totally worth skipping flyering for an hour and go to that show. So my decision was correct. Take that. And make it back up. See you tomorrow. Back on the Royal Mile. Where shit is going down. And after 10 minutes of flyering, I'm going back to the venue to support another show, which is at our venue. Because Theo said we should do that. So yeah, sure, why not? Let's watch the show. Yeah, I haven't done that in a while. I mean, in the end, I should not be so sad. I am sad, but I should not be sad, or at least I'm in a bad mood and I should not be. I just saw an okay show. It had a nice concept, but their tech didn't work, and so they let us sit there for 20 minutes, so that was awful. Because then I'm thinking I'm wasting my time. And also I'm thinking, yes, there are other people who could do a better job in comparing. For instance, Clem, I think she would do a great job. It's just, my problem is just that all it took my opportunity away, just to have a better show. But as there is no reviewer in today anyway, because it's midweek, he could have let me try it. I think it's just a selfish thing of him to do. I mean, I don't know. I don't really know his reasons. I think he wants the best for the show, and he thinks he can do the best for the show by comparing himself, which might be true. But on the other hand, it is taking my opportunity away, and I have been one of the first to say I want to compare, and I could have, and Tom couldn't. because there was no space for him. But then I persuaded Theo first and then also Ollie to let me do the Wednesday show, because I wanted the challenge of a not so enthusiastic audience. I wanted the challenge. I searched for the challenge. I specifically asked to do the Wednesday show, and that means there was a spot open for another day comparing, and Tom got that spot, and now I asked Tom if I can have it back, and he said no, he really wants to compare as well. So I can't compare anymore, and that is not so cool. But oh, whatever. Way worse things could happen. I could properly injure me on stage, that would be worse. I mean, I injured myself a little bit yesterday. Here, I got bruises. Or one bruise. But yeah, it's really not the worst thing, because I know that I can do it. I would just like to have proof that I also did it, so I could show people a video with a big audience and myself standing there and comparing. But I'll just have to prove myself in Graz then. I'll just set something up and start a show in Graz, because I know how it works. Can't be so difficult. And if there is something coming up, I'll improvise, because I'm a freaking improviser. That's what you do. Oh yeah, okay. I have peace for eating now. Don't think about it, get it out of your head. That was a really good show. How did you feel about it, mister?
Brilliant. So well.
That was such a good show.
It was. That's why we're all so hyped now.
I'm so happy. That was just wonderful.
I'm really happy with my improvising today.
You did amazing, Andy.
Thank you.
Awesome.
That was so good.
Yeah, see, we all feel like that's been our best show so far. It's only going up from here.
Only going up.
Yay!
Did you record your object prop scene, the walking one?
Yeah.
Now
Loads of money.
5 quid in there.
Yeah, how much did we make?
Today was Wednesday.
When you're dancing, I have to
tell you.
It's just too much to just get it straight away.
92 pounds 43, 2/3 full. Not so bad, huh? Not so bad. Ollie, the compere of today and our director, said he does not regret his decision, which is fine. And yes, although he was not happy with his own comparing because he forgot a lot of things, because he wanted to promote other shows and he wanted to thank one of the Kickstarter bakers. Backers, not bakers. And he does not regret the decision because I was so great!
Oh, he was so great! I was better!
And everyone else in the group was great too!
Oh, that looks good. But yeah, that was probably the best improv show I've ever performed in. Or let's put it like that, it was the best improv I've ever done. Ever. Because I don't know why, maybe the whole being down about the whole thing made me want to show him, here you go. You will regret not giving me the part. So I don't know. At first I thought it would be worse because like I won't have any energy because I'm like, oh fuck this cast. Oh fuck the director. But in the end, when I'm standing on stage, I forgot about all of that and I was just living in the moment. I was just full energy. Whatever I have, I'll give it. And it turned out to be good. Because today we really had a working cast, because today we really had a proper warm-up and we were hyped because we did 15 minutes of warm-up and everybody knew we need to get the energy in to have a good show. And so all of the people were motivated. And if all of the people are motivated, I can do a much better job because I rely on the other people. But also I did a very good job myself. I'm so happy that I came up with the flashback thing. I mean, I saw that in so many improv shows, the flashback, and I always like it. So today I was like, yeah, let's do that. We've never rehearsed it like that, but just, we're improvisers, still have to deal with that. Also, I like that I could put some German scenes in, like because Theo was talking about Germany, and so I was like, "Ooh, I can work with that. I can just talk German." Ollie, why behave? Yeah, please end my vlog with make your backup together.
With what?
Make your backup.
Make. I just need to say make your backup.
Yeah.
Okay.
3, 2, 1.
Make your backup!
What is all green?
Ollie. Backup your face.